I know there are people who don't think being transgender is a thing, and this video is not for them. This video is for the people who say, yes, trans women are women, but they are still biologically male.
To license it. Random radio special reports. Make sure you guys hit the bell right next to the subscription button so that you guys always know when we have brand new content up. Yes, for those of you like my friend Kels, yes, that includes the Random Radio podcast show and the Random Radio video show. Yes, all of it. You're gonna know when all of it is up. Jesus Christ, Kellen. You're annoying. All right. Today, we have a reaction video. This is not our favorite tranny. This is not Blair White. Blair White is our favorite tranny. This is probably going to be our most hated tranny. We're not going to like this tranny, I have a feeling. I don't think any of us are going to like this. This is Riley J. Dennis. Riley's a trans whatever. Who is extremely liberal. Yes, and he, she, it is going to explain to us why trans women are not biologically male. Riley, do your best to try to convince us to think like you. Let's start.
I know there are people who don't think being transgender is a thing, and this video is not for them. This video is for the people who say, yes, trans women are women, but they are still biologically male. Because while their intentions might be good, the impact that these words have is actually very harmful. Trans women are not male, and saying that they are allows some people to justify the mistreatment of trans people. So
whoa. Wait a minute. Riley is trying to convince us that trans women are not biologically male. I mean, you do know that these are men before they turn into women, right? They're men, so biologically they are men.
So I'm going to assume that you already really believe that trans women are women. If you don't believe that, this video isn't meant to convince you. Maybe instead of leaving an angry comment, you could go do some research into what it means to be transgender. I will leave some links in the description to-
Why would I need to go and look into what it means to be transgender? I can just go look into what it means to be a man and a woman, and then that's pretty clear cut.
Boys have a penis, girls have a vagina.
Because transgender is really confusing. Like, it really doesn't make sense. First of all, transgender, transvestite, transsexual, there's too much. Transfat, transparent, translucent, it's too much. Transportation, it's too much. Too much trans fat, too much all of it. I'm tired of trannins, tired of trans, everything. This is silliness. Riley J. Dennis is silly.
Some very good resources to get you started. All right, so let's say that you're trying to be a good ally to trans people and you heard that sex and gender are two different things. Sex is biological and gender is a social construct. That's not entirely true.
What? Sex and gender are two different things. Gender is a social construct and sex is biological. What? What? Did you all just hear that? Sex and gender are two. So your sex is male. But your gender is male, but the gender is a social construct, but the sex is biological.
Sex and gender are two different things, but they're both partly social constructs, just in different ways. For a long time, gender has been assigned to people based on their perceived sex. A doctor looks at a baby's genitals and determines what gender it will be raised as. In our culture, this used to be unquestionable fact. You were raised as the gender you were assigned at birth, and being transgender wasn't an option. This doesn't mean that trans people didn't exist, we've existed as long as humans have existed, but being transgender was not a mainstream topic of discussion.
Why should it be? You all only make up like 0.4% of the population, and I'm sure when the new census comes out, you all will probably only make up 0.8% of the population. You all are not, you're a fickle of a minority. You're like a speck of the United States. Why does there need to be this? And then you, this is in your head. This is all a delusion that you are having that you want us to be confused with. So now there needs to be all this attention brought to you. I'm telling you, this all started with the blacks wanting stuff. You know, from the blacks to the women to the gays to now these people. Yes, these people. Get offended if you want to. I don't care. So that's how it happened. Because it doesn't make sense. Why would these people need these? Who cares about your delusion?
Today, many of us recognize that gender is far more complicated than a person's perceived sex, and we're able to acknowledge that people can be transgender. Gender was a social construct before, and still is now, but how we construct it has changed. Now we can say that your gender is based on how you identify, because we realized that basing gender on perceived sex was oppressive. Again, I'm not really talking about society at large, because a lot of people still don't fully understand what it means to be transgender, but I mean within trans-accepting communities. However, even within these communities, binary sex has, for some reason, stuck around as the same kind of unquestionable fact that we used to think gender was. I've made a video before about intersex conditions and how sex isn't a perfect binary, but for now, let's just talk about what it means to be male or female.
Dude, do any of you all understand what was just said to you there?
Now we can say that your gender is based on how you identify, because we realized that basing gender on perceived sex was oppressive. Again, I'm not really talking about society at large, because a lot of people still don't fully understand, but I mean within trans-accepting communities. However, even within these communities, binary is the same kind of unquestionable fact that we used to think gender was. I've made a video before. Isn't a perfect binary, but for now let's just talk about what it means to be male or female.
Boys have a penis, girls have a vagina.
Do any of you understand what was just said to you? That I don't. I'm confused. This dude just told us a riddle, because I don't know what the hell he just said there.
Because I would argue that sex needs to go through the same change that gender has already gone through. It's not a static fact, it's a social construct. I'm sure that some people are having this knee-jerk reaction that sex is based on biology and you can't change a person's biology, but that's exactly what we used to say about gender. Sex is a way of categorizing humans based on a combination of a few traits: chromosomes, genitals, gonads, hormones, and secondary sex characteristics like facial hair or breast development. Most people never have their chromosomes tested. They're not tested at birth and they're not tested at regular checkups. Unless you're doctor suspects that something might be wrong with your chromosomes, you'll probably never have them tested in your life, and you certainly can't tell a person's chromosomes by looking at them.
You see? They want you to believe that the delusion is inside of them. It's inside of you too. It's in your chromosomes.
Hormones are also not visible without a test, and genitals and gonads are usually not visible most of the time. So the way that most people have of determining someone's sex is simply their secondary sex characteristics that developed in puberty. Before puberty, children with penises and children with vaginas are really not that different.
Penis, girls have a vagina.
The rush of hormones around puberty that begins to develop the secondary sex characteristics. People with penises tend to develop facial hair, gain muscle mass, and get a deeper voice. People with vaginas tend to develop breasts, get wider hips, and have more subcutaneous fat. But these are not perfect differentiators of sex. Some people with penises don't develop much, if any, facial hair, while some develop beards, and the amount of facial hair that they have doesn't make them more or less male. The same goes for people with vaginas. Some of them will develop large breasts, some of them will develop small breasts,
and up top, two-piece things.
But neither of those is more or less female. There's a lot of overlap between these characteristics. Some people with vaginas will have deeper voices than some people with penises, and some people with penises will be shorter than some people with vaginas. It's not like all people with penises fit into one box and all people with vaginas fit into another box. It's like they're all in the same box, but people with penises tend to hang out on one side and people with vaginas tend to hang out on the other.
What are we hearing? What are we hearing? What the hell is this man saying? What the hell is this person saying? What are they saying? This is foolish.
Plus, all of these secondary sex characteristics can be changed, either through hormones or surgery.
If you are changing your chromosomes or your hormones through surgery or drugs, it is not natural. I do believe that there are hermaphrodites or intersex people. I believe that. I believe that there are some women who have more testosterone than other men. Some men have more estrogen. I believe that. That does not mean they are not biologically still the sex or the gender that they were at birth, Riley. And I'm confused. What the fuck are you talking about?
When people assigned female at birth take testosterone, they tend to get deeper voices and grow more facial hair, while people assigned male at birth can take estrogen and develop breasts and more subcutaneous fat. And if puberty blockers are taken before hormones, a person assigned female at birth might never experience a female natal puberty.
Hormone blockers, puberty blockers. Did you hear that? A drug. Oh, Riley. What has America done to you? What have we done to you? I'm sure you were once a good boy, thriving, playing sports, being a boy. And then the world did this to you.
Or vice versa for people assigned male at birth. So the sex you were assigned at birth doesn't necessarily tell you what secondary sex characteristics you'll have later in life. That means that telling someone you know their sex based on their secondary sex characteristics is just not true. But you still think you can tell someone's sex based on their genitals or gonads?
Penis, girls have a vagina.
Well, genitals can be changed with surgery. Some people assigned male at birth have vaginas, thanks to a surgery called vaginoplasty.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Fellas, you know what? All you people out there who are comfortable with your sex, you have no problem with the social construct of your sex or gender, I'm telling you right now, watch out for Riley Dennis's out there. Watch out for people like him. One, he's ridiculous. Two, he's telling you right now the facts, the hashtag facts. There are people out there who will not tell you guys that they're men running around with fake vaginas. There are women out there, ladies who will not tell you that they are women running around with fake penises. You won't find out until you start getting in between the sheets like Isley Brothers. Coming on strong, in between sheets. Oh yeah, you won't know. Be careful. Be careful. R. Kelly, tell him.
That's stupid. Use your common sense.
That's right. You know what? Even if you do use your common sense, guess what? They'll still try to get you. Because misery needs company.
Some people assigned female at birth have penises, thanks to a surgery called phalloplasty. So genitals aren't a great indicator. And gonads, so ovaries or testes, are often removed in the case of testicular or ovarian cancer. But if a woman has her ovaries removed due to cancer, is she no longer female? If a man has his testes removed due to cancer, is he no longer male?
No, because biologically he was still born a male, and he still has male functionality inside of him. You said it, the chromosomes, the hormones. He's got testosterone. His testosterone levels is high. He still can produce semen. His body was once producing semen. If his testicles were taken away, still his body was producing semen, which means that he's a man. Riley.
I don't think so, and I don't think you can say that gonads define a person's sex without believing that. So out of the five ways we have of determining someone's sex, four of those five, hormones, secondary sex characteristics, genitals, and gonads, cannot be accurately used to determine someone's sex. For example, if someone was assigned male at birth but took puberty blockers and hormones and had a vaginoplasty, they would have female hormones, secondary sex characteristics, and genitals. So three of their five ways of determining sex would be female. They wouldn't have male or female gonads at that point, and let's assume their chromosomes are XY.
No. Let's not assume shit. And this person took drugs to do all these things. You know what, Riley? You have not convinced me. This person's variable is they're doing drugs. God damn it, Riley. I'm gonna ban you.
That means that 3/5 of the sex criteria point to female, and only 1/5 points to male. And if you believe that sex is an unchanging biological fact, that couldn't be possible. But it is. Here's where people say, well, you can't change your chromosomes. And yeah, that's correct. But if you want to argue that sex is entirely determined by chromosomes, then you're arguing against the definition of what we call biological sex. Because sex has never been only about chromosomes. It's been about all 5 of these traits. And tell me, what good does dividing people based on their chromosomes do? If chromosomes don't determine your hormones, secondary sex characteristics, genitals, or gonads, what purpose do they serve in differentiating people? The answer is, they serve no purpose.
I think it's funny that a person who wants to look like a woman, he's done all the dimorphic things that he can to like a woman, hair's like a woman, he's trying to make himself, he's wearing clothes like a woman, is talking about what it means, the social constructs and all this shit, when he's trying to look like a woman as much as possible. Not like he's just being a man saying he's a woman. He really believes he's a woman. So he's got to dress up. Isn't this female appropriation? Shouldn't women be mad at this because he's appropriating their culture, their lifestyle, their clothing, emulating them? And he's doing a bad job at it because he's terrible looking.
There's no reason to divide XX people and XY people. That is an arbitrary distinction that has no effect on how the person looks or behaves or navigates the world. You can't know someone's chromosomes by looking at them, and even if you could, it wouldn't give you any useful information about the person. That's the point I'm trying to make. Sex is not a biological fact because it is determined by things that are largely changeable, and the only part of it that is unchangeable doesn't have any real world effect. So it is just as much a social construct as gender is. But I'm not saying that for a trans person to be trans, they have to have all the surgeries and take all the hormones. A trans person is trans if they claim that identity.
No, Riley, that's not true. A transsexual is a person who has done all of the post-op surgeries and medicines and all of that stuff. They are a transsexual. You have to change your sex in order to be a transsexual, which I don't know what you're talking about, Riley, because all of those things that you just mentioned would be involved in the changing of the sex. You have to change the features on the outside, which means you have to get some titties and a breast and a vagina. Then you'd also have to change the inside of you by putting estrogen inside of you if you were a man turning into a woman, testosterone of you if you're a woman turning into a man. So you're going to change. The only thing you can't change is your chromosomes. You can't change that, but you obviously can change your hormones. So this is all biological. It is all internal. You're still a man because guess what? When the coroner comes and picks your dead fucking body up, they're going to call you a man on the paperwork. Now, whatever. The world, the pastor can call you whatever the hell you want to be called. But you will be a man on the paperwork. Well, I don't know. Maybe not now because now they're letting you call yourself gender X. So maybe you'll be an X on the paperwork. But the bottom line here is this. If you have to do all you do. That's how you become a transsexual. Yes. Not to be a transgender person. No, Riley. All you have to do is just say that you are of this gender. That's all you got to do. I'm a part of this gender. And then you know what you get to do? You get to act like the gender. So then you get to utilize the social construct, I suppose. So fine, Riley. If you want to say that, I guess genderism is a social construct. Sure, that's what you all have made it. Us who are normal and who like ourselves and are not looking to hurt ourselves by becoming the opposite sex, we don't have to see it your way, Riley. We don't have to accept your truth. We will accept the truth. And we will just live our lives just fine. Why don't you go do what the most of you all do and go and commit?
Because a cis person doesn't become trans when they have their ovaries removed due to cancer. And a trans person isn't cis just because they can't afford hormones. Having a vagina doesn't make you a female.
Boys have a penis, girls have a vagina.
Regardless of whether you were born with it or got it through surgery. Gender is about your identity, and therefore, so is sex. The fact that sex is so fluid means that thinking of sex as a binary, unmoving fact of life is just wrong. So if you're a trans woman, you're female. If you're a trans man, you're male. And if you're neither a man nor a woman, then you're neither male nor female.
You see? You can be nothing. I am a turtle.
I like turtles.
Biological sex has to undergo the same paradigm shift that gender did. We need to start thinking about it as a social construct rather than an inarguable fact. Because when people say that a trans woman is biologically male, they use that as a way to attack trans people.
Now it's an attack to call you what you are. If I tomorrow turn around and say I am trans race, I am actually Asian, and you call me black, you are attacking me. You are attacking me! Clearly this brown skin is Asian.
use it as an excuse to exclude us from bathrooms, locker rooms, and other women's spaces. It's just a more subtle and more socially acceptable way of discriminating against trans people. You might mean well by saying that sex and gender are two different things, but I think it's important to emphasize that both are social constructs based on your identity. This video is a part of my Feminism with Riley series that I'm doing in collaboration with Everyday Feminism, a website dedicated to helping you stand up to and break down.
Okay, that's enough. Feminism with Riley. Okay, you know what? The only Riley around here at Random Radio that we respect is this Riley.
Look, fuck you, fuck the plane you flew in on, fuck them shoes, fuck those socks with the bell on it, fuck your gay ass fairy faggot accent, fuck them cheap ass cigars, fuck your yuck mouth teeth, fuck your hairpiece, fuck your chocolate, fuck Guy Ritchie, fuck Prince William, fuck the Queen. This is America. My president is black and my Lambo is blue, nigga. Now get the fuck out my hotel room. And if I see you in the street, I'm snapping the shit out of you.
That is the Riley we respect. Riley Freeman, you are the only Riley we respect. And Riley, I'm going to let you have the last word. Please, do give us the honors.
Y'all niggas are gay.
Thank you. Leave some messages in the comment section. I think I'm going to ban Riley Dennis from all future Random Radio episodes because this is pure nonsense. See you guys maybe tomorrow. I got to decompress from this foolishness we just heard. Random Radio.
Yeah, boy. You are listening.